Hi there everyone, welcome to the Recoverit channel, a place where we help you resolve unexpected technical issues with your digital devices. We're back with another episode, and in this video it's all about you MacBook users out there. In this video, we'll show you how to fix the Mac got stuck at the Apple logo problem. We'll walk you through some of the different ways to boot up an unresponsive MacBook that's been stuck at the Apple logo. Before that, why don't you click that subscribe button and notification bell so you don't miss out on any future videos. Now, before you unleash your technical side and start opening up your MacBook, take a moment to simply do a hard reset of your MacBook. Yes, it is simple, but a surprising number of people don't perform this simple fix. A hard reset terminates all the startup applications that might have caused the MacBook to be stuck on the Apple logo screen. As a result, all the processes will resume and you'll be able to boot up your MacBook without any interruption. To hard reset the MacBook, simply press and hold the power button for around 5 seconds. Once the MacBook completely shuts down, wait for a few seconds and then press the power button again to boot the device from scratch. In case a hard reset doesn't solve the problem, the next step would be to boot your Mac in safe mode. For viewers who don't know what safe mode is booting a safe state that only loads the essential system processes while booting up the device. Follow these steps to safe boot your Intel Mac. Start your Mac and then press and hold the Shift key. The Apple logo should appear. When the login window appears, release the Shift key and log in. You may be required to log in twice if you have File Vault turned on. Now follow these steps to safe boot your M1 Mac or newer. Press and continue to hold the power button until you see the startup options appear. Choose your startup disk. Press and hold the Shift key and click continue in safe mode. Release the Shift key and you'll be able to boot in to safe mode. Hopefully this will allow you to fix the MacBook stuck at the Apple logo issue and boot up the device without any hassle. If your MacBook fails to boot into safe mode, you might want to try resetting the PRAM and NVRAM. The PRAM and NVRAM are two small chunks of non-volatile memory that hold crucial information such as display resolution, sound, time zone, and more. When you boot up the MacBook, your system automatically fetches this information from the NVRAM and PRAM and ensures a smooth user operation. So, any unexpected error with these two memory spaces can cause errors like the MacBook stuck at the Apple logo. If that's the case, then you can simply reset the PRAM and NVRAM. By the way, this only works with Intel MacBooks. First, power off your MacBook. Once the device is completely shut down, press and hold the Command, Option, P and R keys together on your keyboard and keep holding them until you hear the startup sound. Release the keys and your device will automatically boot normally. Sometimes when the Mac won't boot past the Apple logo, there might be an issue with the SMC or System Management Controller. It's responsible for managing low-level functions such as keyboard backlighting, battery, and thermal management. So any issue with the SMC could cause your MacBook to get stuck at the Apple logo screen, and resetting the SMC can resolve the issue on Intel MacBooks. First, press and hold the power key to turn off your MacBook. Now connect your MacBook to a power source and then press and hold the Command, Shift and Control keys together for 10 seconds. After that, press and hold the Command, Shift, Control and Power keys together for 10 seconds as well. After, your device will turn on normally. If the error is being triggered by the SMC, you won't have to deal with it anymore. If none of the previous solutions worked, there is a possibility that you are dealing with a hardware-related problem, so running disk utility could help. But since your MacBook won't boot past the Apple logo, you have to put it into recovery mode first. Press the power button and then press and hold the Command and R keys together simultaneously until you see the Apple logo on your screen. On M1 MacBooks, press and continue to hold the power button until you see the startup options. Let go of the keys and you'll see the macOS Utilities window on your screen. Here, select Disk Utilities to proceed further. Now select your primary drive and tap the First Aid option at the right-hand side of the screen, at the top. a confirmation button will pop up on your screen. Simply tap the Run button to diagnose the hard drive for any unexpected errors. Finally, if you've had no luck so far, the last option would be for you to visit an Applecare specialist to get the device repaired properly. However, before that, you may want to run an Apple Diagnostics to evaluate the root cause of the problem. Not only will it make their job easier, but it will allow you to decide if spending thousands of dollars at the Apple Care Center is worth it or not. To run Apple Diagnostics, first press the power button until your MacBook is completely turned off, and then after a few seconds, press the power key again to turn on the MacBook. Press and hold the D key and select your chosen language. Your MacBook will then start scanning the system, and a progress bar with checking your Mac message will appear on the screen. After a while, you'll see a list of all the possible errors with your macOS along with their error codes. Make sure to take a photo of these error codes as it will allow the technician to diagnose the issue more quickly. If you have come this far, you might have to leave your MacBook at a repair center. But before you do that, we would suggest that you recover the data from your MacBook so that you don't have to deal with any further data loss in the future. Of course, since your MacBook has become unresponsive, you'll need to resort to other solutions to recover the data successfully. We recommend using Wondershare Recoverit data recovery software to get the job done. It will allow you to create a bootable USB drive that will allow you to retrieve all of the data from your MacBook, even if it's stuck at the Apple logo screen. Let's quickly walk you through the step-by-step procedure to create a bootable recovery media using Wondershare Recoverit. Install and launch Wondershare Recoverit on another macOS system that works properly. On its home screen, select System Crashed Computer in the left panel and then click Start to get started. Connect a USB drive to the computer and use the drop-down menu to select it. Then click the Start button again. You'll be asked to format the USB drive before proceeding further. Click the Format Now button and then press Format once again to complete the process. Wondershare Recoverit will automatically start creating the bootable hard drive, which might take a few minutes. Meanwhile, make sure that the USB drive stays connected to your computer. Now that your bootable recovery media is ready, you can connect it to the crashed MacBook and start with the data recovery process. So that wraps up our video on how to troubleshoot the MacBook stuck on the Apple logo error. We understand that getting stuck at the Apple logo screen can be a nightmare, especially when you are encountering it for the first time. But since it's not a severe technical error, you can easily troubleshoot the problem and make your MacBook responsive again. So drop a like and comment down below if you found this video helpful. And to see similar videos in the future, don't forget to hit that subscribe button and notification bell to the Wondershare Recoverit YouTube channel. Anyway, thanks for watching and we'll see you in the next one. Bye.